Thank you, really, everyone. It is now to deliver awards. So please, Director Dabolkar, I ask you to join me. I leave you the pleasure of inviting an incredibly special guest. So please join me here.
Oh, hi, Srini. Okay, we're coming almost to the end of the day, and it's a particularly pleasant task for me. As they say, I mean, ICTP was not created in a day. It started with Salam, whose legacy we have talked about. But over the years, many other scientists and directors and deputy directors sort of put their shoulder to the wheel and have made very important contributions to the development of ICTP. So as we look to the future, I want to sort of acknowledge and connect to the origin of ICTP and how it has developed over the years through the work of my predecessors. I'm very glad that two of them are going to are here. Actually, Fernando is here in person. Fernando Quevedo, and Katepalli Sreenivasan, known to most people as Srini, was going to come. He was was deciding to come, but he had to cancel at the last minute. But fortunately, he is able to join us on Zoom. So welcome, Srini. And we have, of course, really wonderful representation from the Salam family, including some of the young, budding great-grandchildren of Salam are here. But I think I want to, I would like to invite Dr. Aziza Rahman. She is the eldest daughter of Abdus Salam. Please, Aziza. So I had the pleasure of visiting her in her home in Los Angeles. She told me that among the four children of Salam, she's the one who took to science, and she's the biochemist, not a physicist. So I thought that this would be, we thought that it would be a very nice way to acknowledge the contributions of all the previous directors. Unfortunately, Virasoro passed away, but we have two of the directors here, and we were planning to give a small commemorative gift to them. But before that, I will give the floor to Aziza.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, on behalf of the Salam children, the grandchildren, and the great-grandchildren, I would like to thank the International Center for Theoretical Physics and Professor Atish Navulkar for the opportunity to join you here today for this very special occasion. It's been a real honor to be here to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics. It's a place that's touched so many lives and shaped the world of science in very profound ways. In 1946, almost 80 years ago, my father boarded the Cunard Star SS Franconia and sailed from Bombay, India to Liverpool, England, and then on by train to Cambridge University. It was a journey that not only was the beginning of a remarkable scientific career, but it was also the inception of the extraordinary vision fueled by his experiences, both as the only South Asian student at Cambridge and the lack of academic opportunity in his homeland. This center and the remarkable progress which it has made and is continuing to make is a testament to this vision and to his belief that science is mankind's common heritage with a universal language, and all scientists, no matter their nationality or background, are entitled and deserve to have a place where they can come together to pursue, as my father said himself, be re-energized in their knowledge for the betterment of humanity. Turning this dream into reality was a formidable challenge, and my father worked tirelessly to overcome the many obstacles and to secure the support and the resources that the center would need. This meant that he had to make personal sacrifices also, especially the sacrifice of time that he could spend with his family. I don't think I can remember a time when he was not traveling, trips to different areas of Asia, America, and Europe, and we ended up with a very good collection of postcards. But once the center was established, his being away from home became pretty much the norm. However, he didn't neglect our education. He would send us essays and workbooks to do, which he would check every time he was home. So as you can imagine, we would eagerly look forward to our summer trips to Trieste. I vividly remember the first time we visited Trieste in 1965. The center hadn't yet relocated from Piazza Obadan to Miramare, and we stayed in the Adriatico, which was a 5-star hotel at the time. I remember the drives along the shoreline from the hotel to the center, always stopping for gelato. In those days, Trieste was a sleepy little town and not much going on, so having exotic-looking foreigners walking around town was quite a novelty. But for us, it was a wonderful new experience, enjoying the beauty of Miramare, the incredible blue sea, the food, and the thrill of almost becoming millionaires after exchanging a few pounds for lira. In later years, we would stay in the villa with my father and spend the time with him in the center. I remember meeting with Professor Dirac and his family one summer and only realizing his importance in physics when I took courses at university. As I said, I'm not a physicist. Today, we commemorate 6 decades of groundbreaking work and global collaboration. On behalf of the Salam family, I want to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the past directors, Miguel Virasoro, Katepalli Sreenivasan, and Fernando Quevedo, and all the members of staff who have dedicated themselves to nurturing and sustaining ICTP. As you know, we established the Spirit of Salam Award to keep the memory of his inspirations alive. I know that I speak on behalf of all the Salam children, the grandchildren and great-grandchildren, that we will continue to do all we can to maintain our links with ICTP and promote the ideals of the Salam. I would also like to thank the present director, Professor Atish Dabha, for his sincere dedication and efforts to ensure that ICTP not only continues to thrive, but continues to evolve, adapting to the needs of today's scientific world while remaining grounded in the values upon which it was built. If my father were here today, he would not only be very proud of the work being done, but also humbled by the unwavering commitment of so many who have helped to keep his dream alive. I think he would have been quite satisfied, and those of you who knew him would know that he was not easily satisfied, by the spirit and energy of ICTP today, and also seeing the greater number of women that are here today. On behalf of my father's memory and the Salam family, thank you all for being here today, and thank you for the work you do every day to keep the legacy alive. May the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics continue to inspire, to challenge, and illuminate the path forward for generations to come for many, many more decades. Thank you.
Center. Okay, hi. Good morning, Srini. Good morning.
Good afternoon.
Okay.
Yeah.
So maybe please go ahead if you have a few you want to, if you would like to say a few words.
Yeah, thank you, Atish, for letting me say a few words. And colleagues and friends, thank you for being here for this occasion. Already much has been said about ICTP, particularly by the earlier panel, and I will only make a few personal remarks. ICTP remains very special to me, and I appreciate being part of this event, even though regretfully only remotely. I recall with great pleasure my term of 7 years at ICTP. I gave it my best, and my steering committee at the time offered to extend my term indefinitely against all rules, but I could not infuse the same level of energy that I had put into the task for 7 years. As it turned out, soon after I left Trieste for New York, I was drawn into a very complex task here, which was very important for the university. But I say this to convey to you that in spite of that, the work I did at ICTP was much more satisfying to me because it resonated with my ideals, which is why I continue to love ICTP. ICTP was created within the context of the geopolitical situation of the time. And as Dr. Aziz Rahman already said, it was also shaped by Professor Salam's own specific experiences and the lessons he drew from them. It was also shaped by the interests of the visionary local leaders like Paolo Budnich and the extraordinary support of the Italian government. So ICTP has always been an institution inspired by several loosely connected ideas and dreams. Thus, it always demanded some dexterity to negotiate one's way through all this. The world context has changed even since the time I left ICTP, and quite dramatically in the last 60 years or so. So there's a great need for ICTP to reinvent itself. The pressures are all the more real because an institution like ICTP cannot be created in today's political climate. During my term at ICTP, I made a report to UNESCO about various regions in the world requiring more focus. Some of these regions have made progress since then, but alas, some have regressed. It's probably a Sisyphean task, so we should always continually struggle to do our best. Luckily, other elite institutions in the world are now open to engagement with developing countries. Yet, ICTP is special and needs our support, which also means money. I raised some $200 million here in the last 7 years or so, and I continue to raise money, so I have some idea of how to raise money. The main point is that the art of fundraising is and requires an articulation of a compelling goal. And I hope ICTP will develop a compelling goal and agenda in the modern context and will successfully generate funds to propel it to higher levels of excellence. I always thought that the case for ICTP was excellence and diversity together. It's important for ICTP to uphold excellence, but it should not forget that its future is more important than its past. I congratulate ICTP on reaching this milestone and thank Atish and its wonderful staff for their service and the numerous scientists all over the world who still think they belong to ICTP. Thank you again for giving me this opportunity to say a few words, and I assure you that none of this will fade away from my memory anytime soon. Bye. Thank you, Atish.
So now Srini will try to give you the commemorative award on Zoom. This we have done before, so we are quite experienced. So I request Aziza to come forward. And you would like Omar to join? We have to position ourselves at the center correctly. Here is to you, Srini.
Yes, I can see a little bit of that, one square inch of the space, but thank you very much for it.
First accept it, then I will show it to you closer to the camera.
I am very grateful to ICTP and to you for this, and I am very, very glad to accept it from Dr. Salam's daughter, whom I met before. She may not remember me.
Hey, here it is. If you can see.
The photons are not coming my way yet.
Okay,
but it's okay.
Yeah, we will send it to you.
Don't worry about it. I'll rejoice it and keep it with me.
Thank you, Srini. Thank you very much.
I'll stay on, though.
Yeah, please do. Please do. So I now request Fernando, my good friend, Fernando Quevedo.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. It's very strange to be here because, I have been enjoying the last 24 hours being here after 5 years, actually 5 years and 10 days since I left. And for me, this is a very emotional moment because I met many friends and from every component of ICTP, from the maintenance, from transport to media, to scientists, to people serving the coffee, everybody. And so it's very nice to see that we're part of a family and it brings me back a lot of good memories from people that I really care and I really appreciate. So it's very emotional also in that sense. First of all, I want to congratulate ICTP for this 60th anniversary. I can see that it's going very well. The presentation of Atish this morning was very impressive, which is it's very good to see that there are things moving and making good progress and see that the institution is in good shape and I'm looking at the future. So it's great to see. And so it's and also good to see everybody here. I have to say that when I was a director, I learned very quickly that how difficult it is to be a director. And so then I learned to appreciate the previous directors, not only Professor Salam, who was the big person who created, had the vision and the idea to create this, and he had been my role model since I was a student. He came to Texas when I was starting my PhD in the early 1980s. And I saw him as a, like the big star at that time. But then I had the honor to get my first job offer from him for my postdoc, also close to a million in the Berlin Libres. But then I didn't come here, but I went to CERN. But he kindly offered me to be here for 3 weeks before I joined CERN. And during those 3 weeks, I got to talk to him, my level of appreciation grew, and he left a big mark to me after talking to him. We didn't agree on everything we discussed. I have to say, I was very naive, and then I participated here in many activities, coming to the standard string theory school and workshop that is still going on, probably the oldest one in the world, in the springs every year. And then I came as a lecturer, then as an organizer of activities, and I ended up receiving an email from Srini at that time that if I wanted to be considered for the director, which I never thought about that possibility, and then at the end I got the courage and then I managed to get the position, which is, it was a great honor for me to be the director for 10 years. And it's, I still keep it as one of the most important moments, or most important periods of my life, because it made my life much more meaningful in that sense than I was. Not only doing research, but contributing to the mission, this very important mission of ICTP and to the world. So in that sense, I'm very thankful to ICTP in that regard, because it made my life much richer. during that time, I got two pieces of advice from the previous two directors who were alive at that time. That's Miguel Virasoro and Srini. And both of them emphasized something which is, I always keep in my mind. Say, please continue doing research. Because you are here because you're a scientist, and you have to continue doing science. Don't get just involved in the administration part. The director has to be a model for the institution, so you have to be a scientist, but an active scientist. And Srini actually added that, which I like. He said, if I would not be doing science, someone like you would not have applied for my job. and that's, it's your responsibility to also to peer up this, so that someone who is an active scientist can still be interested in the job. And so we managed to convince Atish to take it, which is very good. So for me, that was a job done. So after that is your problem. So in that sense, I appreciate the directors. As I said, it's because keeping the institution running, just running, is a big challenge. Just keeping it alive. Then making progress is an extra thing, but just keeping it alive and running, keeping with the mission, is a big challenge. And I think I have to thank the previous directors before me. And in that list of previous directors, I have to mention two interim directors who were for a year the directors. One is Luciano Bertocchi. So please bring a round of applause. Yes. Luciano, of course, you saw he was deputy director under Salam's time. Then he took over for 1 year as a director. And when I arrived, I always rely on him for advice, you know, this wise person. But not only that, he was the key person to start a program that I'm very proud that they started in my term, is to create this master in medical physics that was mentioned this morning as one of the most important collaborations with the IAEA. And so I was pleased to see that there are already 200 students from 70 different countries, and the program is going so well. The impact it has had in the world is impressive. And I have to thank Luciano for that, because he was the driving force, and he's still teaching in the masters, and it has been a source of inspiration for all the students and everybody who works in the masters. So thank you very much, Luciano. And the other person is Elio Tosati, that I don't see now. That's Elio, yes. So Elio has been yes. Again, it's a surprise for me because, I have to say I'm kind of narrow person in research, string theory, cosmology. So then only coming here, I got to know closer and closer people in other fields. And that was one of the things I thank to ICTP. And Elio was always a source of wisdom. And he was in charge of the programs for all the activities, all the conferences we have, and so on. And he was the director again for 1 year between Miguel and Srini. And of course, I have to mention Miguel. Miguel is a dear friend. It was very sad. I think it's 21st of July, 2021, if I remember. It's that day. My supervisor, Steven Weinberg, who for me was the God figure for me, and Miguel Virasoro, they both passed away the same day. And so it was very impressive for me in particular. I can tell you that for my 60th birthday, Weinberg gave an opening presentation and Miguel gave the after dinner speech. So it was something that they were both very, very dear, very close. They passed away at the same day. But I had a big admiration for Miguel, and he was always a source of support for me. And then, just to finish, during my time of director, I got big support from the Scientific Council, the Steering Committee, people. Well, for instance, David was always part of the Dirac Medal selection committee, and he was always a source of inspiration. He gave us presentations for the 50th anniversary and so on that we always refer to, so thank you very much, David. And then there were two key persons who kept me running, besides all the colleagues in ICTP, and they were Luciano Maiani and Fabio Svirner, that I can see them here. Fabio was, I always say, was my boss because he represented the Italian government. so we had, and Luciano was the chairman of the Scientific Council. And we worked as a team at the time, which was, I appreciate very much. And of course, I appreciate all the work of collaboration with UNESCO. Lydia was always at a different level. Now I'm glad to see her just representing the top person in science in UNESCO, which I'm very pleased. And the IAEA, I was got support from people from IAEA. So in that sense, we are all thankful to that. For the Master in Medical Physics is one thing, but many other things. So anyway, so that's just to finish. I just thank everybody. And I have left ICTP 5 years ago. And I still have the mission in my mind. I'm still doing things related to the ICTP mission. And any way I can be of any help, so please let me know. But thank you very much.
Okay, I think in this case we can actually give him the award in person. So. Fernando, maybe you can. So actually, Fernando has already mentioned a number of other people who played an important role, and two of the acting directors, the past acting directors are here, and also one of the Saif Ranjbar Dhami, he is the deputy director. Okay, he told me that he might have some personal emergencies, so he couldn't make it, but I request both of you to come forward so that we can have it's a photo op. Luciano. And Aziza, please stay on. So it's sort of going from Salam to the future.